So to implement the full particle filter, the only thing is really missing is the measurement prob function. And that's a little bit more involved because I have to really compare what the exact measurement would be for any robot particle and what I sensed, and compute the probability correspondence between the correct measurements and what I sensed over here. To do this, I calculate predicted measurements using the sense function. Here comes a little flag that I defined. If I set it to zero, then the sense function acts noise-free, which is what I want when computing the measurement model. But even if you left this out, you're going to get a fine answer, in my opinion. But that makes it a little bit more accurate. So that allows me to compute the exact bearings of the landmarks for my particle. And then I can compare these correct bearings, called predicted measurements, with the ones I received. And I do this down here in the compute errors routine, where I go through each measurement, and in two steps, I calculate the error in bearing. First, it's the absolute difference between my measurement that I observed minus the predicted measurement. And there's an I at the end over here. Let's see if you can see this right there. And this difference might fall outside minus pi plus pi. So this line over here just brings it back to the smallest possible value in the cyclic space of 0 to 2 pi. So I'm adding pi, I do modulo 2 times pi, and then I subtract pi again. So this gives me a value between minus pi and plus pi. I then plug this error bearing into a Gaussian. And here's my Gaussian, where I square it, I divide it by my bearing noise squared, compute the exponential, and here's my normalizer that, strictly speaking, I don't really need for the implementation. I can safely omit it because weights are self-normalized. But I left it in, so it's actually really a Gaussian. And I take this Gaussian value and multiply it up into my error function. So for each of the measurements, I multiply in one Gaussian. And the final Gaussian is my importance weight that I return in this function over here. So this is not easy to implement. I hope you got it right. Scrolling further down in my code, I now implement the particle filter as follows. I use 1,000 particles. And this is exactly the same routine we had before when we generate our initial particles. Here I set the noise for these particles to be bearing noise, steering noise, and distance noise. I don't comment out the measurement generation step. I just take the input. And then as I go further down, I just run my particle filter. This is the exact same code you're familiar with. There's a motion update, there's a measurement update, and there's a resampling step over here. All those are the same as before. And in the very end, I just print the result of get position. So if I do this for my example, here's the position I get. And I guess I forgot to uncomment the robot coordinate over here, but if you look at the values over here, 7.0 is about the same as 8, 49 is about the same as 48, and 4.31 is about the same as 4.35. So this particle filter clearly does a pretty good job in estimating the robot position.